Ever wonder why you pee so much when you're drunk? We've all been there. You're at your local bar and you've had a drink or three. And now it seems every 5 minutes you're making a trip to the bathroom. This is commonly referred to as breaking the seal, an urban myth that says when drinking alcohol, once you pee, a seal is broken in your body, which then leads to you using the bathroom constantly. But does our body really have a seal? To find out, we're talking to one of Australia's most trusted scientists to learn all about the science of peeing while intoxicated.
I'll give it to you in 6 words separated by a comma. Drink a 6-pack, comma, urinate a 10-pack. In other words, more comes out than actually goes in. And this is related to two factors, drugs, and alcohol is a drug, and volume, and you're having a lot. So let's look at the drugs part.
For thousands of years, fermented grain, fruit juice, and honey have all been used to make alcohol.
It has a pungent odor and a burning sweet taste.
The Babylonians praised the wine goddess as early as 2700 BC, and the ancient Egyptians were paid in bread and beer to build pyramids. Each worker would only receive about 4 liters of beer per day, so they wouldn't dehydrate on the job. Alcohol impacts neurochemicals related to pleasure, motivation, inhibition, and you guessed it, peeing. That's why moderation is important. Fun fact, on average, the human body is 60% water. All this water fills our organs, tissues, and muscles to help regulate our temperature, distribute oxygen through the body, and flush out waste, mostly urine. This is due to high levels of vasopressin, a hormone stored and released from the pituitary gland that helps the body stay hydrated by maintaining the right balance of water and mineral salts. But when you drink alcohol, your vasopressin levels are impacted and suppressed, making you pee without much control. Basically, it's like removing a dam from your kidneys and causing the drinks to run right through you. And because your body isn't releasing more vasopressin to end the cycle, the more alcohol you drink, the more you'll have to pee. Eventually, this leads to clear pee and possibly dehydration.
It's related to the fact that people have got a certain bladder capacity. Once you get to that sort of 500, 400 mils, you're thinking, probably got to go soon, and you can make it go away. And then 600, you can make it go away. By 700, you've really got to make it happen. What's happening is that you're generating urine faster than normal. How much urine do you normally generate? 1 mil per hour per kilogram of body weight. But when you're drinking alcohol, firstly, you're having huge volumes, and then secondly, for every 200 in, 320 is going out. You've cranked it up from that 1 to about 1.6 or something.
Experts say it could take up to 3 drinks before the peeing kicks in. When you have your first drink, there's already vasopressin in your system, so it takes some time and a couple drinks before the hormone level decreases and urine production ramps up. The more you drink, the worse it gets. And if you're drinking champagne or anything with soda, that could be a double whammy. The carbonation of drinks can cause gas and pressure, which can make it feel like your bladder is more full than it is. There's an urban legend that you can prevent constant urination by balancing your alcohol content with water or holding in your pee for as long as possible. But this could be potentially dangerous, since frequently holding in your pee can cause a urinary tract infection. Nobody wants that.
If you drink more water, it is going to have to leave your body. You're just adding molecules of H2O. They're going into your body. So your kidneys are being programmed, reset to jump throughout more, and you're throwing in more. So you're just going to have to pass out even more again.
Now, some of you may argue that constant urination is not a big deal, and it's not a bad price to pay for having a good time. Fair enough. But be aware, it could lead to dehydration and headaches. So chances are, if you're peeing a lot, you're probably gonna have a hangover.
Can you prevent the drinking the seal or getting dehydrated? No. If you go out in a thunderstorm, you'll get wet. If you drop a pencil off the table, it will fall down. It's just part of daily living. You're just gonna have to live with it. And the thing is that when you're drinking alcohol, you don't really digest the foods that you've eaten until the alcohol has been processed by your liver. So really, you want to cut back on the alcohol a little bit every now and then, Alcohol can be a good servant, but a bad master.
So there you go. If you're peeing a lot, you're drinking a lot. There's no magical seal in your body, just a lack of vasopressin. If you want to limit your trips to the bathroom, then you need to limit the intake of alcohol. Just remember, moderation is key. But you can do whatever you want with your life. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.